Okay, I've got Dev C++ open and we're ready to create a program. So we'll go in, we'll click on File, New, create a new project, and we'll pick Console Application, which just means our output will be displayed on a command line console. Make sure we have C++ project selected, and we'll click OK. It'll create a project for us, and we have a chance to name our project, so we'll just call this one Hello and save that. And notice it created a starting point for us to create our program. We'll talk about all the pieces of this in just a second. And then we have the main function here. This is where we're going to type our code in. So for right now, let's just put in a simple hello statement. So a cout statement that would print hello to the screen, along with a inline, which will wrap it around to the next line. Let me clean up a few things here. I'm going to go up to my view here. We really don't need to see this project window all the time, so let me clear that out for you. Also, this font is fine for me, but just so you can see this a little bit better through the videos, we'll go up to Editor Options and Display Options here, and I'm just going to change my font size to just a little bit bigger and see if that's easier to see. Okay, and so hopefully that's a little bit better. So let's look at all the pieces of our program here. Okay, normally if we looked in the book, we would probably just have this one include statement here for IOStream. IOStream is the library we need to include to be able to do input-output statements. Right now, the only output statement we have is the cout, okay, that would send hello to the console screen. Later on, we'll be doing cin statement, which is a standard input. The standard input would come from the keyboard. So to be able to do cout or cin commands, we have to include the IOStream library. That library is pre-coded. It's done for us. So it's something we can use without having to do extra work. So it's a good thing. In this particular example, since we're using the Dev C++ template they give us, they've got a couple of extra things here we'll explain. So system pause is actually calling a system command. Pause just gives us a pause in the command line window. The press any key message will come up, at least in Windows. If we're in a different operating system, we would need to use a different command there. To use this, though, we need the C standard library, so that's the reason for this first pound include statement. We have to include that. On this third one, we're returning control of the program. They use a constant here, exit success. I'm going to change that, and I'll have you change it for your programs. We're just going to say return zero. That's the standard way of saying my program ran, I got no errors, and we're returning control from this function to whoever called me, in this case the operating system. One other thing here we have to look at is using namespace standard. That's the standard namespace, so std. If we didn't have that, we would have to specify for each input output statement, each command, we'd have to tell it what library it came from. So in cout's case, we'd have to do something like this, where it's std colon colon, and we would have to do that for every output, which may be preferable in some working environments. For our purposes, to keep things a little bit simpler, we're just going to using namespace standard, and we'll always work out of the standard namespace. If we were dealing with multiple namespaces, that makes it a little bit more complicated, but since we're just using the one, we'll stick with that. Int main is our main program. We do have a possibility of passing command line arguments in. We probably won't use that. So it's your option if you want to get rid of those. That's fine because we won't use them this semester in this course. So we could just say int main with no arguments passed in. Okay, and that's our program. Let's execute that so we can compile it. And it will do the translation, so it's translating it now from our C++ code into machine code. And once that completes, we should be able to run it. And so we'll try that now. Go back up to execute and run. And it did what we thought it would do. It says hello and press any key to continue. There's our pause. So I'll press a key. That returns me to this screen. Do realize it's separate steps. Compiling and running is two separate steps, but we also have the option here of clicking compile and run. And it will do the same thing. It'll compile it and then run it. Okay, let's make one little change here just to show you a difference. Let's say hello world. Okay, that will change our output statement. And let's change one more thing here. Let's put another inline and see what effect this has. So we'll run that, compile it and run it. And now notice it says hello world. It gives us an extra new line before it says press any key to continue. Okay, so play with that, put that program in, make a few changes here and see what that does. Okay, one thing we don't want to overlook, don't forget to save your program. So we'll go up. It looks like it already saved it, so it auto saves when you compile. Okay. So let's do a save as. And we'll just pick our documents folder. And let's change the name to something more appropriate. We'll call this our hello program. So we'll click. Type in hello and save. And we should now be able to go out to our documents and find our hello program. Okay. And it's just a text file. We could have done this in a text editor. So we can right click on that and say open with. And if I open it with Notepad, there's our program. Okay, just the way we typed it in before. We just don't get color coding or anything fancy. So for your lab assignments, this is the file, the .cpp file, that you would want to upload, the C++ source file. So that's our first program.